So the answer that I think is best is choice four. Choice two is pretty good, but I think choice four is a little bit better. Choice one and choice three would be really difficult. So let's look at how these look to see why choice four is the best choice. So I need to shrink the choices to have a little more room for drawing. So here's what option one would look like. We have a single list, and the elements of the list are keywords. Each keyword is a string, and the keywords followed by the URLs where that keyword appears. So for option one, we have a list, and it's a single list containing strings. Each string is either a keyword or a URL, and we have the keyword followed by the URLs where that keyword appears. This seems nice and simple. There's only one list. There are two real big problems with it. The first problem is it's hard to tell the keywords apart from the URLs. Maybe in this case, we could say, well, anything that starts with HTTP is a URL, because that's a well-formed web link, and anything that doesn't is a keyword. But we could have keywords that start with HTTP as well, and then we couldn't tell which was which. The other really big problem with this representation is it's very hard to loop over the keywords. To find the next keyword, if we start from keyword one, we don't know which position to look at. There are different numbers of links that each keyword might have, and we'd have to search through every element to try to decide whether the next thing is a URL or the next keyword. So this is not going to work very well. So option one is definitely a bad idea. So next, let's look at option three, which was the other one that I said really would be very difficult. So with option three, we have a list where each element of the list is itself a list. And the element lists are lists where the first element in the list is URL. The second element in the list is a list of keywords. So that would be a list of the keywords that appear at that URL. So this has more structure than the first choice. We can tell apart where the URLs are. All the URLs are the first elements of these lists, and where the keywords are, which are all contained in the second element of the contained lists. The problem with this approach is it's not going to make it easy to look up the pages where a keyword appears. This is almost like having to scan all the pages over again. To look for a particular keyword, we've got to look in each entry, look in the second part of that entry, scan it to see if that keyword appears. If it does, well, then we want this URL in our result. If it doesn't, then that URL is not in the result. But to find particular keywords, we've got to look through each entry, look through all of the keywords in that entry. So this option is not going to work very well. Our goal in making the index was to be able to make lookups fast, so we don't have to look through all the content of the pages, and this representation doesn't solve that problem. So we have two choices left, and I said both of these choices could work okay, but I think the fourth option is the best one. So let's look at why. So this is option B. We have a list where each element of the list is a list, and the element lists are themselves lists which contain the keyword followed by URLs where that keyword appears. This has a big advantage over the first two options. It means it's easy to tell the keywords from the URLs. The keyword is always the first element of the list. And unlike the previous option, it's also easy to go through the keywords. For each list contained, we just need to look at the first element to see if that's the keyword we're looking for. If not, we go in the next one. We don't need to look through all the content in all the web pages. We just need to look at the first element in these lists to find the keyword we're looking for. So that's okay. The reason that I think option D is better is it makes a better separation between the keywords and the URLs. So the difference between this and option D is in option D, instead of the inner list being flat lists that are the keyword followed by the URLs, the inner list has just two elements. It has the keyword followed by a list of URLs. So that'll be another list. And now we have a list of URLs. So this is option D. Each element of the main list is a list, and it's a list that just contains two elements. It contains the keyword, here the keyword Udacity, followed by a list containing all the URLs where that keyword appears. The reason I like this better than the second option is that it really makes a clear separation between the keyword and the list of URLs. It means if we decide we want to keep track of something else, say we want to keep track of the number of times someone searches for each keyword, we could easily do that. We could have an extra element here that keeps track of the number of times someone searches for something. With option B, it wouldn't be that clear how to do that. Maybe we could add an extra value in here. We could add a number in here. We would need to change a lot of code we already wrote, instead of looking for URLs starting from position one, we'd have to start from position two now. Maybe we should put the number at the end to avoid that problem. Well, then we have the problem of we've got to find where the number is. There are easy ways to find the last element in a list, but it's going to make things much more complicated. And if we start adding more and more things, we're going to have a hard time keeping track of everything. Option D gives us a lot more structure. By keeping all the URLs in a list, we can treat that as a list and do things with it much more easily than if it's combined with the keyboard. And we can also do things like add extra elements if we want to keep track of the number of times someone searches for that keyword or any other information we think of later that would be useful to add to our structure. So that's why I think option D is the best option. And deciding on data structures is one of the most important things we do when we build software. If you pick the right data structure, oftentimes the rest of the code is fairly easy to write. If you start with the wrong data structure, say we started with the structure that was choice A or choice C, well then it's going to be very, very difficult. Sometimes it's going to be impossible to write the code in a way that performs well. So thinking about data structures is one of the most important things we do in computer science. We'll see that some more in this course. We'll also have following courses that really focus on this question of how to design and use data structures well.